I want good afternoon from Sri Lanka to my colleagues from around the world. I'm pleased to join you at this challenging time for us all. Since the focus of this meeting is on the status of the cultural sector, I would like to briefly mention the situation we are facing in Sri Lanka. As my other colleagues may know, Sri Lanka has a written history spanning over 2,500 years. Therefore, we depend heavily on the cultural sector to enhance our tourism sector, which brings in significant revenue to the country. In 2018, the tourism sector recorded a revenue of more than $4 billion. Unfortunately, since then, we have faced many difficulties, including the Easter Sunday attacks last year, and now the COVID-19 pandemic. To try to contain the coronavirus outbreak, the government has shut down airport arrivals. Therefore, the tourism sector and the cultural sector have come to a complete standstill. As soon as international travel resumes, we hope to restart our cultural and natural heritage tourism under strict health and safety measures. This will allow us to restore the livelihoods of thousands of people who depend on cultural tourism, creative industries, hospitality, and leisure industries and SMEs that are associated with cultural and natural sites. However, the reopening of cultural institutions, sites or space will be done only after a comprehensive assessment of potential risks conducted by a multi-sectoral team of specialists. Before the COVID-19 crisis, Sri Lanka cultural and natural heritage tourism sector was self-sustained enterprise. However, in the immediate future, it will need government support from the national budget. Sri Lanka may also require international assistance in the future in the form of expert technical advice and material support to develop advanced technologies to protect visitors to heritage sites and local communities from health threats. Sri Lanka looks forward to engaging and working more closely with other countries to develop mechanisms to address challenges and coordinate more efficiently in case of emergencies similar to the current crisis. We would also be interested in exploring opportunities with organizations like UNESCO to allow people around the world to experience Sri Lanka's beautiful cultural and heritage sites, perhaps virtually during this lockdown period. I believe we can use our shared and diverse cultural heritages to help us get through these challenging times together. Thank you.
Dr. Okay.